in Romeo Roselli as the newest member, but Mama Pan wins.
What do you want to bet he steals his mom's payday?
Wow. You want to talk about a Saturday night, Brady?
Why are we selling this? We have the main event. Why are we selling this?
Because it just shows how over the PCA is, Brady. They even take control of the 50-50.
Wow. We get it. They're over with you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event. And what a main event this is for the 49th anniversary. Returning to the ECWA, it has been almost 20 years since Crowbar has appeared in the ECWA. Back then he was known as Dangerous Devin Storm. And this is his wife, Serena, his manager. And could tonight be the night, guys, that Crowbar finally wins the ECWA heavyweight title? I mean, we've seen him in WCW with Daphne and David Flair. We've seen him in ECW. We've seen him in WWE. We've seen him in TNA.
He's a longtime veteran. This is going to be a tough matchup for Sean Carr.
This could be the toughest matchup Sean Carr's had.
I agree. All the experience is going to Crowbar in this match.
I would compare Crowbar to Papa Don with world's more experience.
He said that's his wife at ringside, Serena. She was just fanning herself down there in the corner. Here comes the champ, Brady. Don't say nothing smart. He likes to super kick people,
right,
Brady.
Here comes the man.
He unfriended me on Facebook.
That's good. I don't blame him.
As he should.
As he should.
I should, too.
That belt looks great on him, Brady.
Yes.
That's it. Sean.
Hit him, Sean.
That's right, Sean.
Two, Sean.
Look at this incompetence.
What a joke.
Embarrassing.
I think the music is over.
Sean, he needs to get kicked, Sean. Sean, kick him. Yes, kick him, Sean. Yes.
I don't want anything
yes.
to do with you.
Kick him.
Brady, we warned you, Brady.
Why do you encourage him? You did the same thing with Zach.
Because you run your mouth.
I didn't run my mouth.
You just said you unfriended him on Facebook.
He unfriended me.
That's not what you said, Brady. You said you unfriended the surgeon.
You don't do that. That's the champ.
He unfriended me.
You unfriended the champ, and he almost sent you through the wall.
Oh, Sean hit that kid.
Oh. So close, but so far.
Are these goofy fans serious getting in the face of the champ?
My heart is racing right now.
So is mine.
All the blood is just like rushing to my head.
Oh. I gotta talk to Sean Carr after the show. You can't have missed opportunities like that.
I'm gonna run away when he comes.
Oh, no, you're not, because I'm gonna hold you here.
Well, anyway, ladies and gentlemen, 49th anniversary show. Just want to talk real quick about a couple of recent milestones from anniversary shows past. I mean, wasn't just last year that we saw Matt Sydal, our champion at the time, never been stronger, taking on C.W. Anderson
yes.
for the heavyweight title. And what a tremendous match that was. ECW legend and all. We saw Bobby Shields win the heavyweight title 2 years ago. And what a Papa Don, Chris Wilde, my God. And that match combined at the time the TWA and the ECWA heavyweight titles. If you guys remember, we had an undisputed ECWA heavyweight champion coming out of it and ending the historic more than 500-day reign of Papa Don. That was Chris Wilde did that, but that could all be put to shame tonight. The role that Sean Carr has been on for the last 11, 12, 13 months here in the ECWA, ten of which has he been the champion. Something's going to explode tonight.
And I like Sean Carr because he doesn't put up with any nonsense from anybody. He will super kick whoever he feels like it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Boom.
But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, he has a true legend.
This could be his toughest test yet, Brady.
Sean Carr could run his mouth because he could back it up.
Now, we saw Sean Carr against Papa Dunn. We saw it go the 30-minute time limit. They needed an extended time limit the second time.
That's what I'm talking about, Sean.
Is there any kind of a time limit for this? I didn't catch Bob. I didn't
60.
Catch Bob Ortiz.
60.
60 minutes. Sean Carr might need every minute of it. Or he could super kick him in 10 seconds over. But that would surprise me.
I think it's going to take more than 10 seconds to put Crowbar down, Brady.
Crowbar being the aggressor, slamming Sean Carr hard.
Big side suplex.
And he's already going second rope. Vader bomb.
Thought it was going to be a quick win right there for Crowbar.
Sean hasn't even taken off his vest yet. How good do you think Sean Carr could be, Phil, if he wasn't always running his mouth?
He backs it up, right?
If he wasn't always running his mouth,
I'm just saying,
there's a reason Sean Carr runs his mouth. It's like I said.
If he respected everybody, how good would he be?
The only reason Sean Carr doesn't respect anybody, you see when he walks out, the people don't respect him, and I can't figure out why. The guy's our heavyweight champion. He takes on whatever the ECWA throws at him month after month. I respect him, and he respects me.
Well, I like him, but I don't think he likes me.
He doesn't like you, Brady, and he showed it right before the match.
You unfriended him on Facebook, dude.
He unfriended me. He unfriended me. I just liking sending him memes in the messenger, you know?
He needs to super kick the entire front row.
Funny stuff here and there.
This has been...
I thought we had a good friendship.
This has been a memorable 49th anniversary. The night of the PCA. AJ Pan's mom won the 50-50, Brady.
That's a double payday.
It's a double payday for AJ.
I bet he's already picked her pocket and is in a club somewhere.
And you almost got put through the wall.
That I almost did.
Oh.
Well, we still have the show's
not
over yet.
We still got time, Brady. There's still time for you to go through the wall.
Sean Carr and Crowbar jockeying for position, as they say. Crowbar trying to stay low, hoping to neutralize. Sean Carr, obviously, a very strong young man and quite a few years younger.
Looks like I can wrestle Crowbar.
Sean Carr mouthing off the Crowbar.
I mean, you're talking about the night of the PCA. How about that Azrael match?
What a great, and he won clean in the middle.
Yeah, he did.
Joe Zanoli again, butting his nose in, and Azrael won clean in the middle.
So basically, Joe Zanoli came out and butted his nose in for no apparent reason because nothing happened.
Well, it wouldn't have been fair if they were out there.
It wouldn't have mattered if there was 20 people out there. Nothing happened.
Shoulder
it was a clean match.
Shoulder tackle by Crowbar. Sean Carr sweeps the leg in the cover. Ducks the clothesline. These two men, they're very similar in style.
Front face lock. Into a rollover. He's got him in a pinning combination right there, Brady.
Absolutely textbook. If you looked up wrestler in the dictionary, you'd probably see a picture of Crowbar.
He was a star back in the old WCW, like you mentioned, Brady.
Very successful.
He was a successful star. He had Daphne with him back then.
Also teamed up with another ECWA Hall of Famer, an Ace Darling.
Yeah, I can remember going to see Raw in Philadelphia, And Dangerous Devin Storm was there. Of course, Crowbar had a tremendous match. I don't remember who it was against. And then the very next week, he shows up on Raw.
He's very successful in his WCW stint. Sean Carr has a tough road for this match, Brady.
Bicycle kick. And an Enziguri. Modified Enziguri, but still snapmare. Sean Carr, and here's the aggression.
Oh, big penalty kick right there. Oh, look at this, Brady.
Right across the face and a standing moonsault.
Nicely done by the champ.
Shibata penalty kick into a standing moonsault for a two.
Kind of like Azrael and Bobby Shields, though. What does Sean Carr actually have to do in order to get a three count against Crowbar? I mean, look at the flurry of offense.
Yeah, it's still early in this match, though, Brady. These two guys are professionals. You got to work. Oh, wait a minute. What was that, Brady?
Look at this.
Well, clearly, Serena's more than just a pretty face.
And you know what's funny?
And they came with a plan. Sorry, Phil.
Now, if Sean Carr had somebody out there and did that, you would be the first person to jump up and say, oh, look, what you doing helping Sean Carr? But I noticed, since it's Crowbar's wife out there, you ain't saying anything.
I didn't talk like that. That isn't my voice.
And Keener doesn't even do anything. It is your voice, because you're a moron. Crying. There's a lot. Don't get me started on the crybaby thing.
I mean, I didn't.
I already got heat with some of the wrestlers being Boss Jr.
Well, you should.
I won it, though.
I know.
Come on!
I mean, I didn't actually see Serena trip him. I saw Sean Carr's reaction. So I saw.
Oh, look at this, Brady. It's the old Tajiri move here.
Tarantula.
Tarantula in the ropes.
The problem with that move is there's a 5-second time limit on it. Then you're disqualified. Springboard, modified elbow.
Didn't get over. Didn't make it.
Well, you know what? These ropes must be really slippery if you think what happened to a couple guys here tonight.
I've also noticed that bottom rope's really, really loose.
What are you saying? Our ring crew didn't set up the ring correctly?
Yeah.
Where's Sonny Leach when you need him?
Oh, taking a bath, hopefully, somewhere.
And I thought we were getting a neck breaker, but apparently it's more of a wear down hold, almost like a choke. Sean Carr probably can't breathe. I mean, that right under the chin. He's choking the life out of him.
I still can't believe that.
Words escape me sometimes.
I can't even say the word because it's a family show. You unfriended the champ on Facebook.
I did nerd. Not.
You unfollowed him on Twitter.
Unmitigated nerve of you, baby.
No, I still follow him on Twitter.
You unfollowed him on Instagram.
Big dropkick through the ropes.
Does he have an Instagram? If he doesn't post bikini pictures, I'm probably not looking at it anyway.
Meanwhile, you're following J.D. Browning at every Waffle House he goes to.
Hurricane Rana.
Yes. Oh.
Nice. Knee right to the face.
Knee to the face in the corner. Oh. Big sick kick there.
I think this crowd has been zapped of its energy.
I think they all wanted to see you get kicked, Brady.
I think half of the crowd's drunk.
And Serena on the outside.
And the other half, like the clown next to me over here, needs to be put away.
Phil, are you saying you think half the crowd is related to Craig Prendergast?
Oh.
Did they come to the wrong show?
Yeah, they should have went to the 3 o'clock show.
Meanwhile, in the ring, Sean Carr throwing bombs to Crowbar in the corner.
He is absolutely decimating the former television star.
Face washing him with his boot.
How disrespectful can you get?
Oh, right across the running face wash.
Right across the nose, the bridge of the nose. He could have broken it right there.
Hard. not having good placement. He was right by the ropes for that pin, but Crowbar's in a lot of trouble. He's dazed.
You're right, Phil. These ropes are wild.
I'm telling you, whoever put this ring together needs to be fired. That's what I'm saying. For an anniversary, there's no security. They didn't put the ring up. The sound guy's a joke.
Nobody to sweep the floor.
The idiot is not here to sweep the floor.
Well, as you put it, he's probably upstairs tarring the roof. Cover by Carr, only two. I shouldn't say that. He does a great job sweeping the floor.
We got the best floor sweeper in wrestling history, Brady.
Stop it. I don't know who listens to these things. This could be our final broadcast.
Whoa, I don't think he got it all there.
Doesn't look like it. Carr with the cover anyway, 1-2. I'll tell you what, though, Crowbar, he seems to be wearing down.
I gotta say, I'm surprised that Crowbar has the experience, but Sean Carr's basically been on top since the start of this match, Brady. Just jinxed it as he just got caught on the top rope.
You know, I'm surprised Crowbar actually has this much energy because from what I understood, he actually wrestled somewhere today.
Nice move.
And Sean Carr, second rope moonsault.
Big moonsault. Keener right in good position, too.
But here's the thing, all in one motion, Sean Carr almost flawless. Truly a hybrid as he switches from one mode to another.
He's lining him up for that super. Oh, it was a clothesline. I thought he was lining up for that super kick.
That's it. And the German suplex.
Big German suplex. Didn't get him all the way up there, but it was effective. Sean Carr's in trouble now.
No matter how he hits it, it hurts.
Oh,
Ace Crusher
out of nowhere.
We saw him do damage to Matt Sydal that way to win the title. I'll tell you guys what, win, lose, or draw, it has been an incredible night. The 49th anniversary show, truly the next generation of ECWA, starting to become on display, and what incredible action. You can only catch it live at ECWA Arena each and every month, ecwaprowrestling.com for tickets and information, as well as the schedule, October 22nd, December 3rd, November date still to be announced, and of course, all of 27. As Phil Slide just pops my ears.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know you have a microphone. You don't need to scream.
Does this night get any better?
And a Spicoli driver.
Spicoli driver. Mike Keener just ate the super kick as every month Sean Carr gives us a memory.
I said we were making history here tonight. Oh, please let
Keener
Finnegan or somebody run out and get it too.
Just knocked senseless outside the ring.
Mike Keno a little close, too close to the action, I guess. Unfortunately for Crowbar, the referee is out. He is down, and nobody else seems to be coming out. I think Crowbar could have won
Sean
this.
Sean Carr is coming up from behind with a chair.
Carr's got a chair.
Well, who's going to disqualify him, you know?
Big chair to the gut. Oh, and he plows him in the back with a chair.
There is nothing scarier in this world than Sean Carr with a chair.
I just hope he looks over this way. Look, he broke the chair.
He broke
on
the chair.
Him. Broke the chair on him.
Can you imagine?
The force to hit somebody and break the chair.
Those are the comfortable chairs, too.
Those are the high-end chairs, Brady.
That's what I mean. I'm sitting on a glorified milk crate here.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Sean Carr going for another chair.
He gets the steak, and I get the lunch meat.
Brady's getting the grade D, but edible stuff.
Grade E.
Sean Carr with another chair.
He's going to break another one. My God.
Oh,
no one's going to be able to sit down.
Big shot to the back. Keener is just knocked senseless outside the ring. Fans giving him the thumbs down.
Do you blame
him? I'm giving him the thumbs up.
Do you blame John Finnegan for not wanting to come out?
No, because whenever Finnegan comes out, he eats one too. Maybe he finally got a brain cell in his head.
I actually want Finnegan to come out.
I'll tell you one guy who's not going in there, and that's Phil.
Sean Carr's my friend.
You wouldn't help him end this match?
Oh, smart move by Crowbar.
If
right
you wanted
there,
me
Brady.
To, I would.
Pushed him in the corner with the
with
chair
the
on
chair.
His back. Oh, look at that. Oh, big suplex onto the chair.
Holding on to it, too, and the pinning. Look at this.
He could have pinched his hands underneath, though.
Pinning predicament. We still got no referee.
I doubt Sean Carr didn't have the wind knocked out of him there. Maybe worse. Maybe some internal bleeding or something. The way these two men have treated each other in this match.
Look, you figure this is the time where Joe Zanoli actually has to do something and nothing's being done. They're in there throwing bombs at each other. Right now, it's all for naught, Brady, as we don't have a referee.
Right, there's no, Sean Carr's not retaining the title. And Crowbar's not winning the title, not without a referee.
Yeah, we need somebody down there to make a count or make a decision.
The only thing I can say is one of these men could quite likely kill the other man before the referee wakes up.
Oh, on the chair.
Valley driver on the chair.
Absolutely punishing, and again, the
still no referee.
Wait a minute. Oh, here he comes. Finnegan.
Oh, come on.
Here comes Finnegan.
Just in time.
Sean Carr gets out of it.
Oh, thank you, John, for coming out because I know you're going to eat a super kick.
There is a good chance.
John Finnegan is like the pet that keeps doing something stupid, like jumping up onto the stove while you're cooking. Every time he runs out, he eats a super kick, and here he is again.
The difference being right now, Sean Carr is on the defensive. These two men.
Crowbar's moving
Crowbar's
the table.
Grabbing a table and pulling at the ringside here.
You can hear it across the concrete floor. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is a concrete floor.
Concrete floor. He's got the table set up. Lord knows what he's going for.
This could be it for Sean Carr.
Sean
needs to put through this table.
Sean needs to get away from that table. Wait a minute. He's setting him up.
Suplex him into it?
He's setting him up for a suplex, it looks like.
And I think Carr has blocked it and reversed it. He's going to. Oh! Crowbar reverses it. Oh, right into the table. He
right
could have impaled him.
Right into the table.
Stop counting.
They're up to seven. Sean Carr broke the count.
That's it, Sean. That's what I'm talking about. Don't let Finnegan count on anything. You go out there and you hurt Crowbar.
Sean Carr nailing him face first into the table.
My body is in pain just listening to this. Carr rolls back into the ring, and he wants Finnegan, referee Finnegan, to count. This could be it right here. Is this really how Sean Carr wants to retain the title? Miss Serena just looking on.
Crowbar is up, Brady. He's staggering around in front of us. Oh, no, he went down again.
I don't know if he's getting up in time. I think the crowd trying to will Crowbar to his feet.
Come on, Finnegan, count.
And he just made
just
it.
Just barely makes
how
it in.
How did he get in? But, you know why? Because Finnegan with his slow, stupid counts allowed his favorite to get in the ring.
But here's the booby prize. He comes in and Sean Carr just kicking him right in the lower back.
Big forearms. He's got him draped over the ropes. Sean Carr's on a mission right now, Brady. He's got all the momentum. And he's smiling while he's doing it.
Crowbar, a little bit of life left in him, but these two men are giving it their all. And it's all in honor of a 49-year-old company. Started in 1964.
Oh, there it is, Brady. That could be it.
Started in 1967, and Sean Carr, what a great living tradition.
Super kick number two by Sean Carr.
The lineage. And it all culminates with Sean Carr tonight. Can he beat Crowbar? Can he beat ECWA's past and continue to forge the future of the very company that he represents?
Serena is trying to throw Crowbar back into the ring. He looks out of it, and she is trying to put him back in the ring.
It's not very loving.
He looks.
I think Crowbar's basically giving it up. Now Sean Carr going after Serena here. He's
telling her to stay out of the way.
You know, she better watch herself. She doesn't know what she's doing.
She better watch her mouth.
Come on now. It's enough of you. Come on. For God's sake.
I don't think Sean Carr would hesitate to kick her.
I don't blame him.
John Finnegan getting in the way here.
Oh! Yes, Sean! Yes, Sean!
Yes! He just
Sean! Hit him, Sean! Hit him, Sean! Knock him out, Sean!
Knock him out!
Knock him out!
Sean Carr just
yes, Sean.
Serena to never, never land. Brady
Love it. That's what happens when, you see, she wants to be part of the show, helping her stupid husband out. She gets what she deserves. She interfered early in the match, Brady. You saw it.
Brady, she got what she deserved.
No business being out there.
Inside the ring, Sean Carr's got the belt.
He's got the
big
belt.
Big red, and he's going to clobber Crowbar right in the...
Come on, Sean, hit
right
him
in
the face.
Poor Lady Serena. She's done.
Big shot to the
might be
belt.
Come on, Finnegan, get in there, John.
Come on,
get in there.
And this could be it. Sean Carr with the cover. He did use the belt. And that's out.
Oh, you see with the slow count.
If Finnegan was in the ring doing his job, this would be over.
Ladies and gentlemen, what an incredible night. My God, the fact that
Sean, punch him in his face.
Crowbar found a way to kick out, the resiliency.
Sean Carr is absolutely out of control. He just super kicked Crowbar's wife, Serena, in the mouth.
Clearly deserved it.
In his defense, she did interfere in the match twice. She shouldn't be out there interfering in the match. That's what happens when you want to get involved, but good gracious. Sean Carr has sent Mike Keener and Serena into dreamland.
Sean Carr sent a message to everyone. He will super kick you no matter who you are.
Sean Carr, front face lock.
Oh, no.
Drives the back of the head hard down to the mat. Does Crowbar. These two men, as I mentioned earlier, so evenly matched.
Drop kick into the corner.
Crowbar's got him in the corner.
What's he looking for?
What's he looking for?
I think he just realized his wife's gone from ringside.
Swoops the leg. Oh, leg drop right across the midsection.
Yeah, you're being generous right there with the midsection.
And the pinning combination. The both these men have given it their all for the fans tonight.
I think you're right, Brady. He just realized she's not out there. I don't think he saw what happened.
Well, I wouldn't blame him for not seeing it. He was knocked pretty loopy himself.
He might not know what's going on, Brady. Crowbar, and he's bringing a chair in. Crowbar bringing a chair into the ring.
What is it with these high-end chairs getting used?
Crowbar, John Finnegan.
Finnegan stepping in.
Stepping in.
And it's set up for the super kick.
Oh,
and
again.
One.
Another one.
This has got to be it. Sean Carr with the cover, our championship ring.
Yes.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That is our champion once again. 49th anniversary show in the books.
John Finnegan probably thinking he was doing the right thing by saving Sean Carr from being hit with a chair, but he wound up costing Crowbar the match.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Sean Carr has proven that the company is and will continue to run on hybrid power. Sean Carr decimates Crowbar. What an intense physical matchup.
I love it.
Mike Keener went
awesome.
Flying. Lady Serena went flying. Crowbar went flying.
And John Finnegan almost gave it again right there.
I almost got it too.
Brady almost got it.
I'm not letting it happen to me though.
What a night.
Brady,
magical.
You better be on alert.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for checking out this DVD edition. We're live on the network of the 49th anniversary show, ECWAProWrestling.com for tickets and information. Upcoming live shows, don't forget the Facebook, ECWA-East Coast Wrestling Association, as well as the Twitter, at ECWAWrestling67. What an honor. What a great night of action, guys. So many debuts, three title matches tonight, four title matches tonight.
Awesome. Bobby Shields leaving the company. Sean Carr once again defending his title against Crowbar. PCA adding a new member. Referee Phil Sly returning the refereeing.
Big Gino wins his first match.
Who cares? All I'm saying is, what a night. 49 years. I cannot wait until the golden anniversary of 50 years next year.
Well, that is a huge one as well. But ladies and gentlemen, what a great company to work for. Truly the prime real estate of the independent wrestling industry. And all this action you can only check out by coming out to the ECWA Arena.
This belt ain't going nowhere.
The Woodbury Heights
nowhere.
Community Center, 741 Helen Avenue, right here. In
Sean
Woodbury
Carr.
Heights, New Jersey.
He's going over to Joseph Holy in the corner.
Right.
Joe's not paying him any mind. Joe, you better
he's
get
crying,
out of there.
He's crying, Sean. He's crying. Sean, he's crying.
You,
Sean,
better,
crying.
You better get out of the way, Joe. Brady, you better wrap it up before you get one.
We got to get out of here, guys. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you for checking out the show. And we'll see you next time.
Blog Talk Radio, every Monday night, 7 p.m., Bossy Chair.
business. I owe this company a great bit of money. Gratitude. Love to come back to see you guys whenever.